Greetings. Let's address these one by one. Why did Jesus say, if he did not leave, the Comforter would not come? A. Because Jesus was going to send the Comforter. And B. Because if Jesus stayed, his disciples would not have learned to be dependent upon the Holy Spirit. Why was Jesus in a hurry to leave? Because God had a timetable, and the Holy Spirit needed to be sent on the day of Pentecost. You can watch the video about the seven feasts of Israel if you want to know more information about that. Wasn't the Holy Spirit already in the earth? Yes, but the Holy Spirit did not live in people. He came upon them, and then he would leave. This new condition is that the Holy Spirit would never leave believers again. Does anyone else fit the definition of the Comforter? When you read the whole set of descriptions and comments by Jesus about the Comforter, it is simply impossible for a human being to literally fit the description. The Christian revelation of the Holy Spirit is the only consistent definition of the Comforter which can literally fulfill Jesus' words. Jesus said he would be crucified, and he was. John 18:32, that the saying of Jesus might be fulfilled, which he spake, signifying what death he should die. John 11:51, and this spake he not of himself, but being high priest that year, he prophesied that Jesus should die for that nation. Matthew 16:21. From that time forth began Jesus to show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised again the third day. Luke 4:6. He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spoke unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and the third day rise again. And they remembered his words. So what questions beg to be asked and answered? Is the Christian position consistent? Yes, Jesus said he would die. And Jesus never once said he would escape death. Did any disciple of Jesus deny his death? No. Every single disciple continued to speak and teach that Jesus died on the cross the rest of their lives, at constant risk of death and torment. So is the Christian position that Jesus died on the cross consistent within the Bible and the message of Christianity? Absolutely in every way. Is there any non-Christian, contemporaneous, historical document which denies Jesus died on the cross? No historical document denies this historical fact. Jesus said he would rise from the dead, and he did. Where did Jesus say he would rise from the dead? Matthew 16:21. From that time forth began Jesus to show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised again the third day. Jesus was crucified on the cross and died. This is verified by the Roman soldiers piercing his side. Yet on the third day his disciples saw Jesus who appeared before them. John 20:27. Then saith he unto Thomas, reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, my Lord and my God. My kurios and my theos, two different words. Revelation 1:18, I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive for evermore, Amen, and have the keys of hell and of death. Does any Christian document or text deny that Jesus rose from the dead? No, not one. Is the Christian claim confused or missing detail about his resurrection? No, the scriptures are clear. Jesus was resurrected and he appeared unto his disciples, and he walked with them and taught them for roughly 50 days. So the Bible record of Jesus' death and resurrection is consistent in every detail. Jesus spoke with authority. Matthew 9:2. And behold, they brought to him a man sick of the palsy, lying on a bed. And Jesus, seeing their faith, said unto the sick of the palsy, Son, be of good cheer, thy sins are forgiven thee. And behold, certain of the scribes said within themselves, This man blasphemeth. And Jesus, knowing their thoughts, reading their minds, said, Wherefore think you evil in your hearts? For whether is easier to say, Thy sins be forgiven thee, or to say, Arise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins. Then said he to the sick of palsy, Arise, take up thy bed, and go into thine house. And he arose and departed to his house. Jesus has just shown that he has the same power to forgive sins as God does. Which is easier, to say, I forgive your sins, or I heal your disease? Which is easier? Aren't they both the same? God can do either. Jesus proved he could do the one by doing the other. Matthew 7:28. And it came to pass, when Jesus had ended these sayings, the people were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one having authority, and not as the scribes. Mark 1:22. And they were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one that had authority, and not as the scribes. Mark 1:27. And they were all amazed, insomuch that they questioned among themselves, saying, What thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority commandeth he even the unclean spirits, and they do obey him. So what questions beg to be asked and answered? Where did Jesus say he got this authority? John 5:22. For the Father judges no man, but has committed all judgment unto the Son, that all men should honor the Son, even as they honor the Father. He that honors not the Son honors not the Father which has sent him. John 5:26. For as the Father has life in himself, so has he given to the Son to have life in himself, and has given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. Is Christianity consistent with the historical record, even outside Christianity? Yes, Christianity and its claims are supported even by non-Christian documents and historians, such as Josephus. Jesus taught the Word of God would not pass away until it was all fulfilled, and there is no evidence today that any portion of the Gospel has been lost or changed. So with the collection of all the manuscript evidence, we have the entirety of the Gospel. Is Christianity consistent with itself, with its scriptures, and with its teachings? Absolutely, yes. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.